Hi everybody, welcome to Metro Pop Art Channel's Best Of Series. We're coming at you live from New Orleans, Louisiana, and I'm your co-host, Wade Sutt. This season, we're going to be featuring everything good about the top cuisine and neighborhood favorite restaurants of New Orleans. Okay, so you know New Orleans is known for a lot of different things, po' boys, etouffee, crawfish, Creole Cajun, but today, we're going to be talking beignets. Don't say beignets, say beignets. And who better to do so than New Orleans Coffee and Beignet Company's Stephanie Witt. Stephanie, welcome. Thank you very much for having us today. Okay, we're going to head into the kitchen, so come on, let's go.
Okay, so Stephanie, thanks so much for having us today. We're going to go through a little bit about the beignet and how to make it. Tell us a little bit about your daily routine.
Well, when an order of three comes up, we'll come over here and grab some dough. It's already made, so it's nice and ready. It's made the night before, has some time to sit, so it gets a nice puff.
Yeah, is there a special ingredient that's involved in putting it?
I think mainly the special ingredient is the powdered sugar that goes on top. But it's just flour. We have our own mix. A lot of flour, a little bit of buttermilk, a little bit of yeast, sugar, rice, a few little odds and ends here. Wrap it on through.
Nice.
It's a little quicker than a rolling pin.
So are there any secrets relative to the flour in getting that great final product that you guys put out to your customers?
It's I think it's a combination of a little bit of sweetness that goes in it and not keeping it so bland, the dough. The combination of the water to the dough is key. So your beignet isn't too dry, your beignet isn't too doughy. I have been with New Orleans Coffee Beignet Company for over a year now. I love it, and I love these beignets. And you're going to drop them into grease. Cook 2 minutes.
Well, according to Linda Stanley from What's Cooking America, the word beignet can be traced back to the early Celtic word beigne, meaning to rise. It's the origin of the French beignet, meaning fritter. Now, like most New Orleans traditions, beignets have been associated with Mardi Gras in France since the mid-16th century, and many recipes for beignets appear in French works around this time. Stradley writes, in the Ursine nuns of France brought the beignets to America when they settled in Louisiana in 1727. Café du Monde, however, attributes the Acadians, French settlers who were ousted from Canada by the British in 1775, with first bringing the pastry to Louisiana. According to the 1902 Picayune Creole Cookbook, published in New Orleans, French colonists brought the custom of serving sweet treats, such as beignets, from the old country to Louisiana.
Well, we prepare ours a little different compared to a little bit in the neighborhood. I think ours are more favored because we do cook ours to order, and we do get a great puff on ours.
Now tell me about puff. What does puff mean? Tell me about puff.
Okay, so when you open up one of these beignets, you're going to see more of like the spider web dough. And not like a solid donut. It's not doughy. It's not like you're eating a cake. This is light and airy and fluffy. And you can eat all three and you crave more.
That's good.
You open them up and you see that spider web, that pocket of air,
nice.
That fluffiness. So that's what makes ours so different and special.
And do you think that's attributed to the actual dough itself?
Yes, and studying it and seeing how it does cook instead of just throwing it in there, we watch it bubble up. We watch it rise.
Yeah. Well, there we go, made to order. Unbelievable.
All right, guys, here we are with the finished product. I'm so excited to try a beignet. Stephanie, thank you so much for your help today. Let's pick this up and let's show people how it's done. Ready?
Yep.
Oh my God. Now you can see why so many people come to New Orleans. Wow, the beignet.
Like it?
Very good.